understand that the system.
You know, in my mind, I'm thinking like, nah, they'll never hear this music. They'll never feel us. They're never coming down here.
God, I think I lost my freaking mind. In the right place, at the right time, I got the right design. Call myself Young Billy D, and it's motherfucking prime. No degrees, no dissing job, but I'm mental full of rhymes. With a will and a drive to maximize my time, cause this time is money, so I don't play with my money. It's economics for dummies, niggas acting for gazy. Switching up when they get a taste of that champagne.
We just make music just based on the love for it. We not motivated by money. We not motivated by, you know, pretty women and the cars and the jewelry and the clothes and all of that stuff. Don't get me wrong, that feels good, having those and being in between that. But we do this just based on the love for the art. Our intentions is just to get the music out there and get it heard, you know, and get some type of spot or some type of placement. First, it starts off, you have an idea. You're putting it down on paper. You're going in the studio. You know, talking back and forth with my man. We come up with a concept. We come up with a beat. And it becomes a song. I just think, in my opinion, music is getting taken for granted. You know, like, we don't truly understand, or we don't truly appreciate some of the music that comes out nowadays. And I understand, you know, like, everybody is trying to be a star. Everybody starts out trying to be famous with the music thing now. But still got people that love this art and people that just live and ride for it.
For all you guys listening out there live, man, we got our special guest in the building. Hey, what's going on, bro? Introduce yourself to the world.
Hey, what's happening, man? What's going on? It's Fruit right here from out of PG County, Maryland. You know what I'm saying? The DMV area. What's going on? What's poppin' with y'all, man?
Not much, not much. Man, you gotta give us a little insight on you. What's the full details?
The full detail? I'm trying to get on with this rap shit.
It's very extremely very tough, you know, coming out the DMV. It's like close to impossible, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, we maintain a certain lifestyle out here, you know, especially when you're an artist. You know, Most of us, you know, we have regular jobs. You know what I'm saying? We work 9 to 5s. You know, just a few of us, you know, dip and dab, you know, in the other aspects of life. You know what I'm talking about? But for the most part, most of us do both. You know what I'm saying? We got 9 to 5s, we got our hustles, and we keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? But as far as I'm concerned, if you can make it out the DMV when it comes to rap music, I know it's probably going to sound cliche, but you can make it anywhere if you can make it out the DMV area.
Black girl, blue eyes, blue as the fucking sky. California loving a company keeps me high. Talking over this loud ass speakers, I think I'm high. I'm guilty of that ratchet shit, must I justify? Acting like a douche, but I bet she let me slide. She love it, in Versace I'm covered, she think I'm fly. We turn up in the club, we getting by. Oh my God, I think I lost my freaking mind.
As I recall way back, you know, starting off, the first artist that we had, like, recognized nationwide, but on still on an underground level, was Black Indian, you know. And that was way back, you know what I'm saying? Most of us were even too young to even remember that far back. But in 2007, you know, this cat from out of Northwest, North, not matter of fact, Northeast DC. You know what I'm saying? Tabby Bonet had his first record, Put Me in a Pocket. I remember when I first heard that on the radio. I was psyched. I was hyped up. Like, how the hell did he get on the radio? Like, going from, if you're from the DMV, you know back then, all you heard on the radio was artists from New York, LA, Atlanta, whatever you want to call it. You never heard an artist that was from here on the radio. That was the first time we heard that. And when I heard that, I was just confused, like, yo, okay, is this the beginning of the acceptance of hip-hop artists in the DMV? But still, it was still on the underground level. And, you know, Tabby Bonet, real cool dude, very talented, but he never did, like, make it out mainstream. So it was still something that we still needed, that person that was going to hold a flag, you know what I'm saying, nationwide, you know what I'm saying? And then came Wale. I started rapping in 2003, you know, and I've seen the DMV going through all kinds of changes. We've gone through the freestyle on the street, battling, we've gone through the open mic nights, you know what I'm saying? We've gone through traveling to other cities and not getting the respect of an actual hip hop artist should get or would get, you know. We've seen it all, from everything you can think about that goes wrong being a hip-hop artist in this generation, or in the past generation before us. I'm just proud, very proud that, you know, people, you know, young guys from out here right now are getting some type of recognition in a mainstream arena of this thing we call hip hop.
Yeah, I ain't got that much on my mind. I'm just trying to have a good time. Cause bad bitches with me, my niggas with me. Get this money no matter I'm a crime. Yeah, I ain't got that much on my mind. I'm just trying to have a good time. Cause bad bitches with me, my niggas with me. Get this money no matter I'm a crime.
Some of y'all acting like Varnell Hill out here. Acting like you ain't never sipped no 211 on Mad Dog. Soon as you got a little paper, you acting like you can't come around the block no more. You know what I mean?
If you were to ask me this a couple of years ago, I'd tell you it's probably the biggest mistake I made. But in 2001, I didn't have a job, I didn't have nothing. Hell, I didn't even have a place to live. You know, I was straight hustling, I was in the streets heavy. So I just figured, you know what? I'm gonna pack this thing up and I'm gonna move out to LA and try my hand as an actor. And that's just what I did. You know, they say sometimes, you know, when you chase a dream, you discover other dreams along the way. And I guess in my situation, that's what this was, you know. I went out to Cali, went out to LA, I had some family out there, kicked it, worked a job, you know, 77 Tower South. South Figueroa Street, downtown LA, you know, where I met a lot of people, a lot of entertainers, and they turned me on to something. You know, I worked for a couple of movie sets with this company named Set Workers. But, you know, as crazy as that sounds, nothing panned out, nothing worked out. So I came right back to the DMV.
But that's cool, all the standing your own tubes. They ain't never comfortable. Spotty looking up to you, and they watch you every minute, so don't fumble. Just stay humble. Now that's the number one model if you play lotto. Cause you believe anything is possible, but you're so skeptical. And it's crazy when acquaintances hoping that you lose. But what else you gonna do? Bills on the table, but I gotta pay the monthly. Cause ever since pushy, cause things is looking fuzzy. How many thinking of me if I fell off at prices like you?
And that's when, you know, I was just giving my man a ride to the studio. And that's how I started rapping. I laid a verse down on one of my man's tracks. I like the way it sounds. I never stopped recording since then. You know, you never know how far you can go with just a thought, you know, or just trying out something, spur of the moment. You never know how far that goes. I just took mine and ran with it. And here I am.
First off, I was on my way to a studio session. I got ran over. I got hit. You know, I got rear-ended by a tractor trailer, 18-wheeler.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? That just kind of like opened my eyes up as far as, you know, trying to, whatever I'm doing or whatever I'm pursuing in life, I got to go even harder, you know what I'm saying? So that kind of like put the battery pack in my back to just go hard. So that's where the motivation came from, chasing the game and all that right now.
All right, so how long have you, you know, you've been paying your dues, you've been in the game? How long, when did you start?
I officially started in like 2005. I mean, I started out in 2003, but it wasn't serious. You know, I was just playing around with it. But I officially got serious in 2005. So I'd say like, what's that, like 8 years?
Okay, all right. So let me ask you this, is what's next for you? What's going on next? What's your next plans in the next few years?
The next few years, my plans, well, I really can't tell the future, but I really want to, you know, establish my brand, like, you know, get bigger.
Sure. I get a glimpse into that fast life, Cuban links, chinchillas, chicks who know, act right, geniuses that lost their life off of that pipe, flashlights, bitches who act trife, get your math right, stash right, yeah. Get in them beats and pieces, promises made to be broken, never make none, cause everybody wouldn't welcome you with open arms, if they on, when you're on, especially if they're money long, industry niggas disappointed when I meet some of you niggas, but that's okay though, get my payroll, PG the Moco, that's the game though, these other niggas trying to make sure our seeds don't grow, we keep the choppers in their backyard for you two-time hoes, long as my neck stay froze, I ain't tripping, cheap liquor sipping, chicken wing and mamba sauce eating. Oh, shit. Gotta put that DC shit in there, you know what I mean? Some of that, you know, DMV shit in there.
I thought I was lucky, but, you know. My homeboy Frank was like, nah, fool, you're not lucky. God just gave you a second chance. And ever since then, I just been going extra hard, just trying to establish myself, trying to reinvent myself, trying to, you know, put every ounce of energy that I got left in me, you know, to pursue a craft that I've been doing for countless years with no type of reward, with no accommodations, you know, feeling underappreciated, feeling like I'm not supported, feeling like I'm all by myself in this world, you know, and I'm just, and I come to the understanding that it takes time, and it takes patience, and it takes, you know, for you to understand yourself, for others to understand you better, and be wise enough in the decisions that you make, and in the moves that you make, and the people that surround you, and the cards that you put in play. You know, this industry is not for the weak. Y'all heard that before. You know, to tell you the truth, I'm the type of person, man, when I put my brain on something or my mind into something, I go the extra mile. And I feel as though, you know, when I see cats like DMX, Jay-Z, it took them a whole lot of years to get on. Took them a whole lot of blood, sweat, and tears. You know what I'm saying? So I look at myself and my career like I haven't done anything. And that gives me motivation and a drive to just go extra hard, you know what I'm saying? And to establish, you know, whatever it is I got going on in the limelight, you know what I'm saying? This EP that I got coming out, I think is gonna, you know, introduce myself, you know, not to the mainstream cats, not to the mainstream world, but maybe to the cats that love music and just wanna hear music and not get caught up with all this controversy and Twitter beefs and you know the whole social network, you know, atmosphere, you know, that's
That's not what I'm into. But if that's what it is, it is what it is. But, you know, I understand that the game now is all digital and it's all about the negativity. But I feel that there's still a lot of people in this world that just like good rap music. And that's what I think I'm bringing to the table, you know. And a little comedic side to it, too, you know what I'm saying? I don't work with that many producers, you know what I'm saying? Like you seen in this, my producer J-Rob on the track, man, he doing big things. And we make some beautiful music together. And that's what I just stick to what I know. I worked with a few producers in the past, but, you know, it wasn't organic. It wasn't the chemistry there, you know? It's just like, you send me a beat, I rap on it, and I put the song out and just... But me and J-Rob, we got like a certain chemistry, man. We work together, you know what I'm saying? We do shit from scratch. And that's how we come, you know, we come out with these songs. It's dope. I love the way we work, you know what I'm saying? And I want to keep that going because I think that's what's working for me. The rap game is crazy, man. The rap game is really crazy, you know what I'm saying? But I keep my appreciation, you know what I'm saying, at an all-time high, you know what I'm saying? Like, I appreciate the people that support me. I appreciate the fans that support me. I appreciate the people that go out their way to, you know, to do things for me and to help me get to a certain level of my career. Shout out to Q the Question. You know what I'm saying? That's it, man. We just trying to showcase this good music to the world and just show them what we bring to the table coming from PG County, Maryland. You know what I'm saying? That's just about it.
It was 1999.